Do you know there are three levels of thinking when it comes to business, when it comes to making money? There are three levels of thinking. And let me tell you the three levels of thinking, because once you understand them, you can choose which level you want to be at or to adopt, right? Three levels of thinking. The first level of thinking about money is that, you know, you're an employee. You have an employee mindset. The first level is being an employee, right? That's that sort of thinking where you go along to your job and you're hoping for a raise. You're hoping you get paid at the end of the week, of course. You're hoping to do a good job and you get paid and rewarded for what you do. Generally, you get paid on an hourly rate, or maybe you get paid, you know, a salary over a year. It's a set amount, gives you security, and you think about, you know, how I can now just live a nice life, do impress the people at work, maybe get a promotion, maybe work my way up, maybe get a raise at some point as well. Okay, so that's the employee level of thinking. And it's a thinking I used to have as well, and it's a good level of thinking, not a great level, it's a good level, because in the end you'll realize that a job, if you're after more money, is not the way to go. Because an employer is always thinking, how do I keep my costs lower? Because they have to keep their costs low in order to make a profit, in order to survive. And employees always think, how can I increase my wage? How can I get paid more? So maybe if you don't get paid more by this company, you change companies, you try and get paid more over there, and you change companies, you know, so you try and step it up everywhere you go, you want to get paid a higher amount. That's an employee's way of thinking about money. I can get paid more if I leave this job and take that job, which is paying more. It's roughly the same job, but I get paid more. So that, then you leave that one, go somewhere else. You know, so that's how a lot of people tend to think about how to make more money. And so it's one level of thinking, but obviously it's limited to your employer wanting you to still work there. So you're in your future's in their hands. You're often limited to how many hours you can work, and because you only get so many hours in the week, so therefore your income's usually limited by how often you can work, how long you can work. So it's an okay way of thinking. And if you're happy with that, that's totally good as well, because you can create a life where you can have whatever you want, do whatever you want to do, get paid as much as you want, or as much as you can, rather, and make do. So there's nothing wrong with that, but there is something wrong with that if you want more, right? If you want more. So that next level of thinking is an employer's mindset. An employer's mindset is where you think, I'll start my own business here. I'll start my own business. And you know, I'm going to start a business and I'm going to do mostly everything. I'm going to get in, I'm going to say, in my instance, I would say, you know, I'm going to build my own websites. I'm going to write my own sales copy. I'm going to run my own advertising. I'm going to find my niche. I'm going to create the product, all that sort of stuff. You do it all yourself because you can do it, because you can. Remember, just because you can doesn't mean you should, but you certainly can. And then maybe you get people to work for you, but then you're trying to keep their wages low, and you've got 3, 5, 10, 15 people working for you. It becomes a bit like a childcare center because you're having to manage all their emotional issues. Oh, this person's sick, this person wants to go on holidays. It's like, did I start a business for this? You know, it's like it all comes with the territory. And if you're happy to put up with that, then that's good too. But you know, generally, you know, most business owners, slash employers, right? Work very, very hard, long hours, and even when they go home, they still haven't switched off, if you know what I mean, they're working very hard, still haven't switched off, and got to deal with a whole lot of blah, blah, you know, from employees that just go with the business. So outside of the business stuff, there's a whole lot of blah, blah that goes with it, from emotional issues, mental issues, physical issues, you know, it just comes with the territory. So again, it's not bad, it's just how it is. That's just being realistic. So if you want to be a business owner slash employer, then that's one level of mindset as well. So there's employee mindset. Next level up is like business owner slash employer mindset. And then there's a third level, which is the level I want you to go to, because it's got much better rewards, much better lifestyle. It's a much better way to live, all right? And that's the entrepreneurial mindset. So employee, business owner slash employer, and entrepreneurial. So an entrepreneurial mindset is where you see the opportunities, or if you don't see them, you find them, all right? You find problems that need to be solved. That's what opportunities are, problems that need to be solved. You find those, and finding them online these days is so easy, it's not funny. We find them in seconds, and if you don't know how to do that, you can come along to one of my events and we'll show you how. So finding opportunities, finding problems, and maybe you've even got ideas right now to start a business because you see a problem and you see a solution. Well done, good on you. Have you done anything with that yet? Or are you still an employee? Or are you still a business owner where it's all just too much, it's very, really busy, you can't get a chance to do it properly, blah, blah, blah. Because an entrepreneur, what an entrepreneur does is actually a lot different. An entrepreneur sees the problem, fills it with a solution, and then steps away. So the business works on its own. So think of it like, Think of it like, remember if you were young, maybe you played with Lego bricks, Lego blocks, and you'd build, you'd build a house, or you'd build maybe a racetrack or something. You'd build it and think, I've built it. Awesome. Then you'd have the joy of playing with it, right? Maybe running cars through it, blah, blah, blah. So you built something and then you're able to enjoy it. And that's what an entrepreneur does with a business. They build something and then they're able to enjoy it. So many people, business owners, employers, tend to build a business and then they go, this is so crap. Yeah, I'm making decent money. Yeah, I got a lot of cars on the road. I got a lot of employees. Yeah, we have a Christmas party. But they're not like pumped about their business. Do you know people like this? Not pumped. They're not pumped about their business. It means they're not in the right model. An entrepreneur, right up the top, can build a business and enjoy the business because they stay out of it. For instance, does Richard Branson fly his own Virgin airplanes? Does he fly them? Nah. As far as I'm aware, he doesn't know how to fly. Maybe he does, but I'm not aware of it. And he certainly doesn't fly them all over the world, taking passengers to where they want to go. No. He's a guy who creates a concept. He's a problem to a solution. Then sets it free by having good people come in and run the business. And that's how an entrepreneur thinks. So do you have what it takes? Because those principles can work in a small business, like especially an internet business, where we build websites that fill their niche-driven businesses, where we fill a problem with a solution. We know people are searching for a solution. We find a solution, give it to them, and we step back and let the business run. That is an awesome business. That's an awesome business, but it requires you to have the third level of thinking, an entrepreneurial mindset where you don't want to do everything. Where you don't want to do everything and be everything. You're not searching for this inner glory, this inner security of having, feeling like a job well done. I have to do it myself so I feel good about myself. You don't have to have that. You can do other things that will give you that fulfillment, by the way. And one of those things you can do is actually build a business. That gives you a lot of fulfillment. That alone gives you a lot of fulfillment. But do you have the mindset? And if you don't, you need to get it. You need to get an entrepreneurial mindset where you are what I call the general of the army. The general of the army. So the general controls the army, controls all the pieces. Not actually in the trenches fighting, controlling all the pieces. And that's how you need to think of your business. That's a much better business if you're the general of the army, the entrepreneur of the business, where you're apart from it, but you still control it. It's all about ideas, it's about training, it's about execution, but you're not involved in the day-to-day. Okay, that's a much better business. And it can actually create some good jobs for people who like doing that as well, who like being part of the puzzle, who like doing all the smaller tasks, the more minute tasks, the perfectionist tasks. That actually can create good employment for them too. So, it's a win-win. So there you go. Three levels of thinking when it comes to making money, having a business. That is the employee mindset. There's the business owner / employer mindset and the entrepreneurial mindset. That is the one you want to be. That's where your brain needs to be. If you don't know how to do that, get some books, read some stories, watch some videos on YouTube about entrepreneurialism. Follow the folks that you really like, that you respect, that you hear a lot about. Follow them, watch videos. Take time out of your day to watch videos, read books, read stuff about these people and see how do they do it? What do they do? What were they thinking? And you'll find any successful, really successful leader is not involved in the day-to-day. They're not involved in the day-to-day. They are the general of the army. And that is a success principle for you. Okay? I'm Brett McFall. That's my view. What's yours? Let me know. Talk soon.